who's this girl? I was in the States and I was surprised. Who's this girl who stood up to the president's son?
I didn't stand up
to him. I want to shake her hand.
I just asked him if he really bought wine during Ondoy.
It's time to answer your tweets and comments about our discussion last week. The chasters, is that what they're called? Or the fans of Cherise took exception to our views on David Foster's planned talent search. YouTube user Public Door One says, Twink is missing the point. There is no entity in the Philippines that can effectively promote a local artist internationally. David Foster can bridge Filipino artists to the U.S. What you said was a crabby statement. Well, my response to that I actually agree with your point. If anything, I was saying that it's unfortunate that given that there are so many Filipinos worldwide in all, you know, of all sorts of spheres of influence, the sheer number, despite that, we still somehow need a Magellan to tell the world, hey, this is what I discovered.
The validation. Yeah. Yeah. The validation of an outsider.
Yeah, I mean, but I would imagine that we would be influential enough to be a force globally just by the sheer number.
I think they're called Chasters because it's Cherise and David Foster.
Ah, Chasters.
I mean, I think.
I'm
making that up.
Well, and can I say, make another point is that, you know, we would never say anything wrong about Cherise because just take a look at us. We all have round faces also. And we would say something bad about Judy Ann
but
Santos.
But because it's Fashion Week, I can pout. And suck my cheeks.
You're not fooling anyone.
User Hooey, H-O-O-I, posted this comment on abs-cbnnews.com about our guest, Carlos Celdran. Celdran has the freedom of speech, but the people inside the church have the right to the free exercise of their religion. Freedom of speech is not a license to violate the rights of others. Unquote. Wow. I guess lahat tayo tama. Everyone's correct on this one. That's the thing.
He did it once, he made his point.
No, but that was precisely his point, I think, because he was saying the church shouldn't meddle in politics. And how does he make that point? By meddling in the, you know, interrupting something religious with something that's not supposed to belong there.
Could it be it was just a physical manifestation of what he meant, which was you're in our Congress halls.
Yes.
So I'm going to step into your church.
Exactly. Yeah.
Do you think there's an effect because he's Catholic himself? And if he weren't Catholic, it would have been a whole different thing.
I think some people just missed the point.
Okay. Or there are so many points.
Some viewers like seeing us in costume. Trixie Moleta tweets, the first time I watched The Brew and I loved it. D. Obispo singles out Gang, saying she looks so bagay on a nun's habit.
On it. That's right. Virgins look good in nun's habits.
D, I think you should know that Gang suffered so much wearing that costume.
Yes, I couldn't swallow the whole time. So yeah, please appreciate your friendly neighborhood nun next time because it is awful to wear that every day.
Can
just
I also point out
they need to go to heaven?
That the gang still apparently thought that we were doing costume night, so she came dressed as a tranny.
I came dressed as a tranny. Check out my lashes and my heels. I'm 6'2 tonight, actually, in these heels.
Well, please. Please keep sending us your feedback. Tweet us, ANC Alert, or at ANC Alerts, or at Gang Badoy, or at Nadia Trinidad. You can also post a comment on the ANC 24/7 Facebook page.
And that's your brew of the hottest developments in politics and pop culture.
Join us again next week for another serving of opinion, insights, and fun, only here on
The Brew.
The Brew would like to thank Loft Details Furnishings.